ressentir un vrai ser. Bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. I began to know Eitan when he visited Japan to see one of his friends, who was then a postdoc working with me in the University of Tsukuba some 20 years ago. At that time, I was impressed by his very nice human character and his already accumulated immense research contributions. Then I wanted to invite him as a JSPS senior researcher at the University of Tsukuba to have the chances of collaboration with him. In responding to it, he visited us for 2 months in 1998. As you may know, Japan is much different from Western countries. During long stay in Japan, some delicate or sensitive foreigners suffer from the difference. But as I observed his character, I guess that Eitan would not suffer from such a problem. That is one of the reasons for that I wanted to invite him to Tsukuba. To my surprise, however, he came to Tsukuba with his family, including his first newborn baby. From my personal experience, I worried that it would be hard for him to stay with a newborn baby in a completely different circumstance. Contrary to my anxiety, he stayed in Tsukuba well adjustably without any problem. And in addition, he seemed to have enjoyed his stay in Tsukuba very much. This seemed to show that Eitan has a big capacity of living besides his great scholarly ability. At that time, we were investigating optimal load balancing in the distributed computer systems. That is, in a sense, equivalent to optimal routing and communication networks. We had already found such anomalous behaviors that under individual non-cooperative optimization, if we increase the system capacity, the social or overall total cost of the system degrades. A couple of years before the Eitan's arrival, we came to know the existence of the Brass paradox. Brass showed the existence of strictly parallel inefficient Nash equilibria in non-atomic networks, that is, with the infinitesimal plates. In the Brass network, we added a new route to the network, the total delay of all non-cooperative drivers increased. We started to find the case of strictly parallel inefficient Nash equilibria in atomic networks with a finite number of plates of optimal load balancing. Then our collaboration with Eitan started. He helped us in discovering the existence of strictly parallel inefficient Nash equilibria in atomic networks of optimal load balancing. The result was published in the paper titled Brass-like paradoxes in distributed computer systems that appeared in I2P Transactions on Automatic Control in 2000. Also, the collaboration with Eitan's research group started after his stay with us. And I arranged a visit to Tsukuba with Dr. Odile Lutarier as a foreign researcher, and that of Dr. Corinne Tuati as a postdoctoral fellow. Further outcomes of the in the line of collaboration is published in the paper Paradoxes in distributed decisions on optimal load balancing for networks of homogeneous computers that appeared in Journal of the ACM in the year 2002. Therein, we found the example of the network when the magnitude of strict priority inefficiency can increase without bounds. Further, we have paper titled A Mixed Optimum in a Symmetric Distributed Computer Systems that appeared in an IEEE transaction on automatic control in 2008. I myself visited Eitan and his group several times at Sofia Antipolis, at Avignon, and at Rome. Other collaborations that I studied resulted in the following research contributions, to name a few. The paper, The Inefficient Non-Cooperation in Networking Games of Common Pool Resources, that published in IEEE Journal on Selected Air Communications in the year 2008. So, the paper Nash-Ethian-based fairness appeared in Mathematical Methods of Operation Research in the year 2003. One day, we talked about the fact that our work on networking games has gained little attention by specialists. Eitan said that the situation implies that we may not have many competitors related to the work and that we can easily pursue the research in that direction without much competition. I'm impressed that Eitan is such a positive thinking person. During the collaboration, I have been getting to know that Eitan is quite multifaceted, as the other speakers said, not only in science and engineering, but also in many other fields, including arts, music, painting, and so on. Only in a tiny part of his scientific coverage, I have collaborated with him. In fact, Eitan showed his interest in collaborating with me in a number of cases where other colleagues of mine did not. That seems to show his very broad coverage of different fields and his great capacity. I wish you everlasting prosperity and happiness. Lift up.